instruction and that is under grace. And we believe in the grace that is upon his life.
Amen.
And we believe in the man that is backing him, that have sent him to this nation.
Amen.
And as we all submit to this same grace, I want you to receive his ministry like the ministry of our Father. Because the pastor of our Father is operating by the mandate of grace that is upon him.
Amen.
So when he stands, he's standing in the grace of our Father.
Amen.
So whatever he tells you to do, jump, please jump. Shout, please shout.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because as you open your spirit to his ministry, the Almighty God will use him as a vessel to bless your life.
Amen.
Talking about no other person but Pastor Prince. He's a married man. We were just talking the same thing as he said, Mother of God.
Amen.
When me and Mama go to Nigeria, make sure to come back with my wife. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He's a wonderful man and he's a man of principle. And so tonight, let's receive the ministry of Pastor Prince. He said, Pastor,
Empress Jude and Robbie Taylor. God bless you, sir.
Better for not to share the grace. Eh? To say the benediction. Would it be better? Because I believe the man of God has done everything. Is there anything left? Are you sure?
Yes.
Praise God.
Amen.
The Bible said, no man take this honor unto himself except he that is called of God. And I strongly believe that tonight, or rather this morning, is going to be awesome. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen.
It's going to be wonderful.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Man of God.
Yes, sir.
Actually, I would have preferred if we can just share the benediction. You've done everything.
You have not started yet.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
God said, I will give you a pastor according to his word. So, which means the pastor God given to you is from his heart. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He's a wonderful man. The Bible said, no man take this honor to himself, except he that is called God of God. Can you please help me celebrate the Sabbath of God? The vision of Hallelujah. Do better. Celebrate your Sabbath. Celebrate. There is a saying that before, that behind every successful man, but my father in the law actually ever to understand that he's not behind. Amen.
Amen.
He's not behind.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Before every successful man, there is what? There is what? There is what? Did you borrow your mouth? There is what? No, not a woman. Successful when single, if he marry a woman that is not successful,
yes.
Tell me what will happen.
Nah,
it will become like a story of Samson,
yes.
Sunrise,
yes.
With Delilah, Sozo.
Yes.
Are you with me?
Yes.
So before a successful man, there is what? A successful woman. Can you please clap that your hand? Celebrate the grace of your father in the house. Hallelujah. God bless you, man. God bless you. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Please celebrate yourself. Celebrate your pastor, your father, your mother. Please, after celebrate. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In this movement, there is a man. God Almighty, to every generation, there is a revelation to that generation. And the revelation being an agent to pilot the revelation.
Amen.
That is why the Bible said, "Doctor, I sought for a man that will carry the revelation to the generation." And in this generation, there is a revelation of restoration.
Yeah.
In this generation, there is a revelation of wiping out tears.
Yeah.
In this generation, there is a revelation of restoring men. And God found a man that has given us a platform, a man that has given us a voice. He's the Jehovah of Africa. He's the Lion of Africa. I call him my life coach. I call him my prophet. I call him my father. He's the prophetic professor. He's the man that carried the mantle of this generation. He's the choice servant of the Most High God. He's the prophet of the God Heaven. He's the man with the voice of dignity, with the voice of power. He's the man that the whole world. He's the hope to the hopeless. He's the head to the hopeless. He's no other person. He's my father. And he's your father. Every time that you have, if you can shout yourself, if you want to clean you to me, let me celebrate. My father, apostle, professor, John C. Superman. Everywhere, just as I said, before a successful man, there is a successful woman. And the world. Prayer and what?
And the world.
My father in the Lord said, the greatest force on earth is the force of prayer. If there is a man to pray, there
enemy. If you know that God will answer you this morning, we let you pray. Because no matter you pray, God has no need to answer. Because you want to pray that God answer. Are you ready to pray this morning?
Yes, sir.
Daily after you. Let my whole life be expression of your glory.
Jesus,
Jesus. and seven. I want you to take some prayer before I commence. The book of Ruth, chapter 1, verse 6 and 7, and Luke, chapter 15, verse 17 to 20. Are you ready to pray?
Yes, sir.
Are you ready to pray?
Yes, sir.
I know you have been praying. What is the prayer point in the book of Ruth? In that book of Ruth, there are some pathetic issues and stories in that book. That is why this morning, I want you to enter in your heart, in your spirit, to pray. I have some prayer points like seven. But we will not take it all because you have to pray. Amen.
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 Amen. What is the prayer point? Number one, the prayer point is my father, my mother, as I pray now, I refuse to remain where life kept me. My father, my mother, as I pray now, you to remain where life kept me. Oh Lord, move me forward in life and in destiny. Because when you look at the book of Luke, there is a man called the prodigal son. I don't know why they call him the prodigal son. It's because he asked of his own portion. It wasn't another man portion. He came to his father and said, give to me the portion that fallen unto me. You know what the Bible said?
Yes, sir.
God, his father, gave him his own portion. So I don't know why they call him prodigal son. But the Bible said, when he used everything, exhausted everything, and he was not good to do with the swan, he cried and said, this is not where I supposed to be.
Yes.
Somebody hear me?
Yes,
this is not where I supposed to be. In another word, I refuse to stay where life kept me, where the situation. The Bible said, I will rise and go to my father. Is somebody hearing me? Are you ready to pray? Can you stand on your feet? Can you start to your feet? Start to your feet. Start to your feet. You are going to pray. Your father told me that you are a man and a woman of prayer. So man is better to see you in that action. Is somebody getting it? Can I just say my father, my mother? Can I just say my father, my mother? As I pray, man, I refuse to remain where God kept me. I refuse to remain